The Trans-Jordan Memorandum was a British memorandum passed by the Council of the League of Nations on 16 September 1922. The memorandum described how the British government planned to implement the Article of the Mandate for Palestine, which allowed exclusion of Transjordan from the provisions regarding Jewish settlement. Background. The British Mandate administration in Jerusalem only ever covered the area west of the Jordan, while the area east of the Jordan was administered by the British representative in Man, Captain Alex Kirkbride, until the arrival in November 1920 of Abdullah bin al-Hussein, the future emir. Following the expulsion of Faisal bin Hussein from Syria by the French in July 1920, and the subsequent Cairo Conference, March 1921, they appointed Hussein emir of Transjordan, while assuring that no Jews would be allowed to settle in Transjordan. Description. Article 25 of the Mandate for Palestine allowed for the exclusion of Transjordan from unspecified provisions of the mandate. On 16 September 1922, Lord Balfour, representing the United Kingdom, reminded the Council of the League of Nations of Article 25 of the Mandate for Palestine. He then told the Council that the British government now proposed to carry out this article, as had always been intended by the League of Nations and the British government. He then presented a memorandum for approval. The memorandum began by quoting Article 25 of the mandate. Then it said, "In pursuance of the provisions of this article, His Majesty's Government invite the Council to pass the following resolution. The following provisions of the mandate for Palestine are not applicable to the territory known as Transjordan, which comprises all territory lying to the east of a line drawn from a point 2 miles west of the town of Aqaba on the Gulf of that name up the center of the Wadi Araba, Dead Sea and River Jordan to its junction with the River Yarmouk, thence up the center of that river to the Syrian frontier." Then it listed Articles 4, 6, 13, 14, 22, 23, and parts of the preamble and Articles 2, 7 and 11, including the Articles of the Mandate concerning a Jewish national home. It concluded with, "In the application of the mandate to Transjordan, the action which, in Palestine, is taken by the administration of the latter country will be taken by the administration of Transjordan under the general supervision of the mandatory. His Majesty's government accept full responsibility as mandatory for Transjordan, and undertake that such provision as may be made for the administration of that territory in accordance with Article 25 of the mandate shall be in no way inconsistent with those provisions of the mandate which are not by this resolution declared inapplicable." The Council then approved the memorandum. From that point onwards, Britain administered the part west of the Jordan as Palestine, and the part east of the Jordan as Transjordan. Technically, they remained one mandate, but most official documents refer to them as if they were two separate mandates. In May 1923, Transjordan was granted internal self-government with Abdullah as ruler and Harry St. John Philby as chief representative.